In this video, we're going to solve this limit problem. Then how to find the limit of this function? Because here under the square root, we have cosine t. And the cosine takes values between negative 1 and 1. To ensure under the square root is bigger than 0, so we're going to consider x is bigger than 1. Because x goes to plus infinity, so it's reasonable to consider this. Now let's look at the range of this function by taking the absolute value. So here, just absolute value of this function. So here, third root x, then the integral from x to x plus 1, then here, sine t divided by the bottom t plus cosine t dt. Because x is bigger than 1, then the third root of x is positive. Then the lower bound x positive, the upper bound x plus 1 positive. Then here the square root is positive. Just sine t could be positive, could be negative. So let's use this maximum value to replace it, which is 1. Then here, for cosine, we use this minimum value to replace it, which is negative 1. Then the bottom getting the minimum value. Then this fraction getting the maximum value. Then here, just less than or equal to. Now the question is how to figure out the integral of this part. So then here, because the antiderivative of 1 over square root t minus 1 just 2 square root t minus 1. Then here, just the upper bound, the lower bound. Then take a 2 outside. Then here, 2 third root of x. Then plug in the upper bound here, that's square root x. Plug in the lower bound here, that's a square root x minus 1. Then here, because x goes to plus infinity, then we want to simplify this part. So then here just, we're going to times conjugate. Then here just times conjugate, that's a square root x, here minus, then here plus. Then just a square root x minus 1. Then divided by the same term. Then here just the square root x plus square root x minus 1. So then combine these two together. It's like a minus b times a plus b. Then here, just a squared, that's this part squared, that's x, minus b squared, that's x minus 1. Then write down the denominator. Then here, square root x plus square root x minus 1. Simplify this part, that's 1. Then on top, just 2 third root of x. Then the bottom here, just a square root x, then plus square root x minus 1. Because this square root is positive, if we drop this part, the denominator is getting smaller, then the whole thing is getting bigger. So that's why here is a less than equal to on top, just third root of x. On the bottom, we drop this one, just keep square root x. Now combine these two together. Then here, just 2 on top. Combine these two together, that's a sixth root of x. Then when x goes to plus infinity, so then this whole thing approaches 0. So now let's see our question. Our question is, what's the limit when x goes to plus infinity of third root of x, then the integral from x to x plus 1 here sine t over square root t plus cosine t. This is our question. Because we just figured out for this whole function, and when x goes to positive infinity, the absolute value goes to 0. So then the limit of this function just equals 0. So then the 0 is the final answer for this limit. Thanks for watching.